First of all, sir, if I could, I'd like to underline your comment about the specificity of the degradation of the Russian forces. Much of the Russian military has not been affected negatively by this conflict. One of those forces is their undersea forces. It's hard to talk in public, as you well know, sir, about undersea warfare and our efforts in that regard. But I can say that the Russians are more active than we've seen them in years, and their patrols into the Atlantic and throughout the Atlantic are at a high level. Most of the time, at a higher level than we've seen in years. And this is, as you pointed out, despite all of the efforts that they're undertaking inside Ukraine.
Okay. Did you catch it?
I did.
Now, I heard that. I had to rewind it several times because he was contradicting Representative Courtney there. And
well,
because Courtney assumed, well, we've been knocking the Russians back on their hind ends.
And I know, but the New York Times and the Washington Post and CNN and Fox and the New York, I mean, the London Times and Telegraph in London and the Daily Mail and the BBC and all the Western media, Doc, they've been telling us every day for a year, the Russians are losing, they're bleeding, their troops are deserting, Ukraine is winning, the Russian army is going to collapse, there's mutiny. It's all a lie, isn't it?
Yes, and you heard that from the commander of the region. I mean,
it's a lie. It's propaganda. It's all propaganda. The Russians are winning.
Yes.
And the only reason the Ukrainians are still there is that the Western nations have spent hundreds of billions of dollars collectively to prop up a corrupt government run by Zelensky, who is stealing unknown amounts of money, he and his generals. And if we didn't prop them up, they would have been wiped out a year ago.